Question 11. If I create a publication with one table as an article, and then change the schema of the published table, for example, by adding a column to the table, will the new schema ever be applied at the subscribers? Answer: yes. Schema changes to tables must be made by using Transact SQL or SQL Server Management Objects (SMO). When schema changes are made in SQL Server Management Studio, Management Studio attempts to drop and recreate the table, and since you cannot drop a published object, the schema change will fail. Question 12. Is it possible to replicate data from SQL Server to Oracle? Answer: yes, this can be done using heterogeneous replication. In SQL Server 2000, publishing data to other databases such as DB2 or Oracle was supported. However, publishing data from other databases was not supported without custom programming. In SQL Server 2005 and later versions, Oracle databases can be directly replicated to SQL Server in much the same way as standard SQL Server replication. For more information, please read tip, Introduction to SQL Server Heterogeneous Replication. Question 13. How will you monitor replication activity and performance? What privilege do you need to use replication monitor? Answer: the easiest way to monitor replication activity and performance is to use replication monitor. To monitor replication, a user must be a member of the sysadmin fixed server role at the distributor or a member of the REPL monitor fixed database role in the distribution database. A system administrator can add any user to the REPL monitor role, which allows that user to view replication activity in replication monitor. However, the user cannot administer replication. Question 14. Can you tell me some of the common replication DMVs and their use? Answer: sys.dm, REPL, articles, contains information about each article being published. It returns data from the database being published and returns a row for each object being published in each article. Sys.dm, REPL, schemas, contains information about each table and column being published. It returns data from the database being published and returns one row for each column in each object being published. Sys.dm, REPL, Traninfo, contains information about each transaction in a transnational replication. Question 15. What are publisher, distributor and subscriber in replication? Answer: publisher. A publisher is any database unit that makes data available to other sources via replication. The publisher can have multiple publications which defines the data to replicate. Subscriber. A subscriber is any database unit that receives the replicated data. It can receive data from multiple publishers or publications. Data can be republished to the other subscriber. Distributor. A distributor is any database unit that acts as a store for the data to be replicated. Each publisher is associated with a single database called as distribution database. Replication status data is stored in distribution database. A distributor can be local or remote. Question 16. What is push and pull subscription? Answer: pull subscription. In a pull subscription, changes to a subscriber cannot be published without any request from subscriber. This allows the user at the subscriber to determine when the data changes are synchronized. Push subscription. In a push subscription, changes to a subscriber can be published without any request from subscriber. The changes can be pushed either periodically or on demand. Question 17. What are different models, types of replication? Answer: there are three types of replication: snapshot replication, merge replication, transactional replication. Question 18. What is snapshot replication? Answer: snapshot of entire data is copied from publisher to the subscriber's database on regular interval. This kind of replication is used for replicating data that doesn't change frequently. It is used where the source can manage with out-of-date data. This replication is considered when amount of data to be replicated is small. Question 19. What is merge replication? Answer: this allows both publisher and subscriber to work independently, online or offline, and merges the changes later. Here changes are tracked on both publisher and subscriber and then merged. Question 20. What is a transaction replication? Answer: it is used when changes are frequent. The replication agent monitors the changes at the publisher and distributes the changes to the subscribers. Transactional replication is required where up-to-date data is required. Question 21. What are the uses of replication? Answer: server-to-server replication, improving scalability and availability, data warehousing and reporting, integrating data from multiple sites, integrating heterogeneous data, offloading batch processing, server-to-client replication, exchanging data with mobile users, retail point of sale, POS, applications, integrating data from multiple sites. Question 22. What are the agents used for transactional replication? Answer: Snapshot agent, log reader agent, distribution agent. Question 23. What are the agents used for merge replication? Answer: Snapshot agent, merge agent. Question 24. What is log reader agent? Answer: log reader agent. The log reader agent is used with transactional replication. It moves transactions marked for replication from the transaction log on the publisher to the distribution database. Each database published using transactional replication has its own log reader agent that runs on the distributor and connects to the publisher. The distributor can be on the same computer as the publisher. Question 25. What is log reader agent? Answer: distribution agent. The distribution agent is used with snapshot replication and transactional replication. It applies the initial snapshot to the subscriber and moves transactions held in the distribution database to subscribers. The distribution agent runs at either the distributor for push subscriptions or at the subscriber for pull subscriptions.